your dream. We were ordering some treats. You said it would be alright. I tried to stop you asking why. You started out to face it. My heart went off like crazy. This is Rimi and welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to show you guys how you can convert your old silk sari, or you can even use a fabric for this gown, and to convert that into a not so plain but a good looking prom gown. This one has been requested for a very long time, especially from silk sari. So I decided to go for this design and this pattern and everything. And since I haven't done this kind of halter neck gowns for a very long time, so I decided I should do something like this instead of the plain sleeveless ones that I usually do. अगर आपको ये वीडियो हिंदी में देखना हो तो आपको कुछ नहीं करना है, जो आप जो ये लिंक होगी इसके जस्ट नीचे मिल जाएगी आपको. अगर आप ये वीडियो फोन पे देख रहे हैं तो आप इस वीडियो का जो टाइटल है उस पर आप क्लिक करेंगे तो डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स खुल जाएगा और वहाँ पे आपको पहली लाइन पे हिंदी वीडियो का लिंक मिल जाएगा. आपको बस वहाँ क्लिक करना है. पर अगर आपको सर्च करना है मेरा चैनल तो मेरे चैनल का नाम है द DIY गर्ल हिंदी, और वहां पे मैं सारी इंग्लिश वीडियोस यहां के जो भी एटलीस्ट जो न्यू बना रही हूं वो सारे मैं हिंदी में ऑन द स्पॉट मतलब एक दिन में या उसी वक्त इसके साथ ही वहां पे डाल देती हूं. हां, आपको जो पुराने वीडियोस हैं मैं जानती हूं आप लोग काफी रिक्वेस्ट कर रहे हैं, वो भी मैं बना के डालूंगी. एज सून एज आई फाइंड सम टाइम मैं उसको भी डालूंगी वहां पे. एंड या आप बस वहां जाके सब्सक्राइब कर ले मेरे चैनल को और वहां पे वीडियो देखें हिंदी में. तो या इफ यू डू लाइक दिस वीडियो हिट दैट लाइक बटन, शेयर विद योर फ्रेंड्स एंड ऑल्सो सब्सक्राइब if you haven't done it yet, and turn the notification bell button on in case you haven't done that yet either. And now without any further ado, let's get started.
For this I'm taking 5.5 meters of tapeta fabric, but you can also use silk sari, then the lining of the same length, that is 5.5 meters. Now imagine this is your entire sari and you need to cut off this much part to make the bodice, and then with the rest of the sari just fold it once like this, and then fold it again like so that you have two folds on this side and one fold and two open edges on this side. Now you have to fold your sari or the fabric the same way I did with the paper. So here you can see I have two folds on this side on my fabric and then two open edge and one fold on the other side. Now take your waist measurement where your top part will end. Now mine is at about 30 inches, and then add about 2 inch for stitching. So it becomes about 32. Then simply divide it with 6.28, which is the formula to get the radius of the circle. So don't think too much, just divide your new waist with 6.28. Mine would be 32 divided by 6.28, which is about 5 inch approx. Now the side where there are two folds, keep your measuring tape there on the corner and mark 5 inch like this in a curved line by keeping the tape at the top corner itself. Now for the length of the skirt portion, I need about 43 inches plus 3 inches for hemming. So the total of 46 inches. Now you can either keep the measuring tape on this curve that we just made and mark 46 for the length like this, or add this much part in 46 so you can keep the measuring tape at the top corner like we did before and mark a neat curved line for the length. So when I add for this part that is 5 inch to the 46, that is the length that I need, that becomes 51. So I'll keep the measuring tape at the top corner and mark 51 curved like so. Now cut the curved lines once done and see on the top side that I reduce the length a little while cutting so that when the skirt falls down, the entire bottom edge is of same length. Now you should have two such pieces like this. And when you open them up, you should have two such big semicircles, one for the front and other one for the back. Now do the exact same thing with the lining pieces and cut them out. Here is my inside part and I have marked both the curved lines, but for the length, whatever your lining piece has, just cut that much. Next, take one semicircle and keep it wrong side up, and then place one semicircle of the inside fabric and place it over the main fabric and stitch both their waist together. And once done, this is how it should look like. Then do the same with the other semicircle piece of both main fabric and inside fabric. And your skirt part is almost done. So keep it aside and now let's make the top part. Take that piece which we cut out at the beginning for the bodice and fold it into half. Then place your folded t-shirt or a kurta over the folded side and trace the neckline and the shoulder and the side seams like we usually do by leaving half inch of seam allowance. And then for the armhole, just tuck the sleeves of the t-shirt inside and trace that as well. And now you can either keep the shoulders and have a normal bodice and attached sleeves, but I don't want that, so I'll be joining the armhole mark with the neckline point like this, and this is how it will be. And for the length of the top part, I'm taking 15 inch plus 1 inch of seam allowance, so total of 16 inches. Now this is completely optional, but I'm adding darts, which gives a proper fitting to the top part. So I'm adding 1 inch at the bottom edge line like this and joining that with the armhole like so, and cut this piece out, and this is how it should look once cut. Now place this piece over the remaining folded fabric, and if you want back zipper, then leave an inch or so at the folded side and place the piece like this and trace everything. But since I'm going for the side zipper this time, I'm gonna keep it like this and trace everything the same way. Once done, just cut it out, so you will have two same looking pieces for front and the back. Now if you went for the back zipper, you will have to cut the back piece into half and attach the zipper before moving to the next step. Since we are not going to do that, so we are going to move on. Now to make the darts, which is super easy, just fold one top piece and mark 3 inch point from the folded side on the bottom edge. Then draw a straight 5 or 6 inch line going up, and then mark 0.5 inch points on both sides of the line at the bottom edge, and then join these points with the top point in a triangle. Now repeat for the other side. Then to make the armhole dart, simply mark the midpoint of the armhole, then from that point mark a straight line of about 4 inch or so going towards the bust dart, and then mark 0.25 inch points, your marks on both sides of the line, and join them with the top points in a triangle as well. Now to create it on the other side, an easy way is to fold the fabric and tap on top of the fabric to get the trace on the other side as well, like this. Now do the same on the back part as well. Now to stitch the dart, just pinch the outside lines together and stitch over it. Now once all the darts are done, this is how they should look. Now let's cut the inside part for the top parts. Just fold the lining fabric into half and place any top part over it and trace everything and cut two such pieces, one for the front and one for the back. Now place the top part right side out and place the inside fabric over it and stitch the armholes and the neckline in place to finish them. Now once done, cut some notches to make the turning or the flipping of the fabric easy. Then flip the lining piece like this and bring the neckline out neatly. Once both the pieces are done, this is how they will look. Next, bring in one of your skirt piece and place it right side out, and then bring one of your top piece and then flip your top piece wrong side out like this and join both the top and the skirt piece waist and pin them and stitch them together. Now do the same to the other top and skirt piece. Then place both the front and the back together wrong side out and stitch one side seam like we normally do. But when you stitch the side seam of the skirt part, first stitch a little with the outside and inside fabric together. But after a few inches, just tuck in the outside fabric inside like so and stitch the inside fabric side seam first. And once done, flip the inside fabric aside and stitch the outside fabric side seam. This way you will get more flare. Once done, this is how it should look. Now to do the other side seam, place your zipper where you want it to start and mark the starting and the ending points and do a regular stitch starting from here to here. Then from where the zipper will begin, do a very loose stitch, and when you reach to the end again, start a regular stitch and stitch both inside and outside fabric together for a few inches. Then separate the inside and stitch it first and then the outside fabric side seam. And that's it. Once done, this is how it should look. Then press open the side seam of where the zipper should be like this, and then pin your zipper in its place and stitch over it. Now I don't want the stitching to be visible outside, so I'll be stitching the zipper on the side seam only like shown. That is this flap, that is, you know, the side seam flap on that, so that the stitch line is visible only on the inside seam like this, and then rip open the loose stitches that we did for the zipper, and that's it, zipper is done. Next, I cut a strap of about 1.5 inch width and then fold its raw edges inside like this, and then use it as a biased piping to hem the neckline and also to join both the front and the back top part together from its neck part, as it doesn't have shoulders. Now you can see that I joined it in such a way that there is some gap between front and the back top for the shoulder width. So basically I started from the back and ended it at back only. So yeah, that's it.
open up your dream. We were ordering some treats.
So yeah, that was it for today's video, guys. I hope you liked it. If you did, please don't forget to hit that like button, share with your friends, and also subscribe to my channel. And don't forget to turn that notification bell button on just beside the subscribe button so that you guys get notified as soon as I upload a new video. I know I've been a little inconsistent in uploading the video. It's because the weather is changing. I get sick. My sister gets sick. So we are not able to shoot regularly and everything. But I'm going to try to do it every Sunday like I promised. And yeah, it's going to be every week anyhow. Maybe it's not going to be up on Sunday because of the weather change. I'm literally getting sick every other day, and even family members are getting sick, so that's kind of difficult to shoot and edit and everything. So yeah, do be patient with me, and yeah, do support me. Do try any of my DIYs, like any of them. And even if you just want to chat with me, you can simply follow me on my Instagram page and DM me over there, or my Facebook page. If you don't have Instagram page, then you can go over Facebook. You can message me over there as well, and I would love to chat with you guys. If I'm available, I'll definitely reply you back on time. And yeah, so yeah, today's feature goes out to Ankita, Sudeeksha, and Suraj. Thank you so much, guys, for your lovely comments. I do appreciate all the comments you guys leave in the comment section below. And even if I don't reply to every one of them, please know that I do read all of them, and if I do find time, I do reply to them as well. And yeah, guys, if you also want to get featured in my next DIY video, all you have to do is subscribe to this channel, turn that notification bell button on, and comment down below whatever you want to comment down, along with a hashtag that is notification squad, so that I know that you guys came right on time as soon as you guys get notified about my video, and I'll feature three of you guys for my next DIY video. So yeah, that's it for today, guys. I'll see you in my next video. Bye.
Open up your dream. We were ordering some treats.